oscilloscope. Okay, so in my last class I have already covered very basic instrumentations of your digital electronics. Okay, so digital electronic instrumentation, so that I have been already discussed in my last class. Okay, so so I am right now focused on that cathode ray oscilloscope. So from this introduction, I think all of you are able to understand that what is cathode ray oscilloscope. So you know that right now, if you see the different advanced digital digital instrumentations, okay, so you have to much more focused about different accurate measuring unit. Okay, so normally we are using that oscilloscope for that measuring purpose. Okay, so what kinds of measuring is there? So if you see, we can able to measure that voltage, current. Okay, so in case of which type of voltage, which type of components, means basically, so AC voltage, current. Okay, both we are able to measure over there. AC voltage measurement, DC voltage measurement, same like that, current measurement. Okay, so we are able to measure over here. Okay, so sometimes we can using the data. Okay, we are storing the data like your if you are doing that voltage and current measurement. So if you are able to measure that instantaneous data, not like that, the term you can say like that, for the time instant. Okay, for the every instant of time, if you are able to catch, or if you are able to fetch that, or if you are able to store the data, okay, for individual instant, okay, of your voltage and current. So what happened, what will be the benefits about it? So you are directly able to calculate all those values. Okay, so for measurement of power, okay, different mathematical tool you can introduce over here, so you can analyze that the nature of the signals, okay, in different mathematical calculations. So some of the calculation unit you have introduced in your system. So how is it possible? Only that cathode ray oscilloscope, then the modified version of that CRO, like you can say like that DSO, means digital storage oscilloscope. Okay, so that we can go for that advanced measurement unit. Okay, so definitely that complexity, then the advanced instrumentations is definitely very high. Okay, so in higher end, so definitely it will be costlier than your normal voltage measuring unit, current measuring unit, like that way. Okay, so definitely it will much more costlier. So what, why and how? Okay, so in this portion, so we have much more discussed about what are the most important features. Okay, what are the most important features of our cathode ray oscilloscope, and discussions about our features, everything. Okay, that we are going to be discussed over here. Okay, so and how it is work. Okay, so what, how, from where we are giving the signal, and after getting the signal, how it is working. So that we are going to be discussed over here. Okay, that's the motivation of this chapter. So first we need to know about the introduction. So what are the most important features we should concern about that measurement. So first we need to know about that, how is it be look like that. So in CRO, how it is looking. Okay, so how you are going to be discuss the CRO. Okay, so different features you need to know about it, then read the instruction. So if you are using any of the instruments, okay, so digital or electronics instrument, you have to go through the instruction manuals. That I have all the time I am told you that manufacturers, okay, those who are manufacturing your measuring unit, so definitely they will calibrate the device with the standard devices, okay, and standard units. Okay, so definitely they will prepare the manual. So how do you know that kinds of constant, which is your actual value, everything? So everything is written in your manuals, as well as it is also mentioned that how much voltage it can be carried out, how much voltage range, current range, then frequency range, bandwidth, everything is mentioned in the manuals. That's why you have to read very meticulously the instruction sheet, okay, instruction booklet, okay, or instruction book that is provided with your measuring devices or measuring units. Break into the smaller parts. So definitely that small unit you have to consider which portion is more important, that you have to be decided. So entire system will be decided, okay, so in the smaller versions, means for input side what is the specifications, then intermediate portions from your input and output, so all the portion wise you can go through it, okay, so when you are using it, how you are using it, okay, so what is the features, okay, so you need to know about the features, individual terminals or individual points, okay, it is not so if you don't know about their working principle, okay, if you don't know its handling methodology, okay, so most important thing is how to handle your device, measuring units, so that is most important. So that's why part wise you have to know about their features and working principle, okay, so which is the work, how it is working, okay, that you need to know from where you are getting that idea. So definitely that instruction book, okay, so all the time you have to follow the instruction books, at least your initial phases. After that you will be expert about that, expert to handle your measuring unit, so then it is no need to go through that time, that instruction manual. So for initial days you need to go through, or you need to read it, okay, then part wise you need to know its working phenomena, then decide on the simple measurements, okay, so then you have to decide that if you know that entire working, how is it working, so you have to use the simplest way, so how to measure the unknown parameters, unknown variables, so that you can decide from your instrument, so increase your level of difficulties, okay, so if you increase more level, so definitely difficulty will be different, okay, so as per the specification, so instrument having lot the generalized specification, so application wise you have to implement, or you have to connect your measuring equipment, okay, to the system, so specifications and where you are going to be applied, so that two portion is most important, okay, part wise study, increase your level of difficulties, okay, record pathway and how got there, so how to record the data, okay, record means integrating factor, recorded data means integrating variable, okay, so it is timed, if that depends upon your time, so how much data you can store from your instruments, okay, that you have to follow, okay, so that portion you need to know about it, so how do you record that data, then store the directions and the shortcuts, okay, definitely, so method you are going to be follow, so that how do you store that data, and finally you can use it. Then most important another parts is that popular instruments is to show times of voltage, both AC and DC shows voltage but time, so definitely there is if you see that CRO, okay, so did you see any diagram of the CRO, okay, so I have some picture with my slide, so I can show you, so normally we are measured that X component and Y component in your X axis, okay, in your X axis normally we are considering the time, okay, that's why it is shown that volt per time divisions, okay, so there is some different segregations, okay, so there is some big unit, small unit, like your scale, okay, so total if you see that channel, okay, so if you see that display, so where you can see lot of marking is there, okay, this means linear marking, like your standard rule or standard scale, okay, so there is some big unit like your centimeter, okay, then small divisions are there, so normally in X axis you are considering the time, okay, so how much time per division, that value you have to know, okay, and in Y axis, so you are going to be measured that voltage, current, like that, okay, so how much magnitude is there, okay, that you can calculate from that Y axis, okay, with the respect of your time, then display waveform, spectrum slow, when the display you can see that wolfram is coming to the skin of your CRT or say cathode ray oscilloscope. So you can get that wolfram. Okay, so from the spectrum scope shows wolfram or the frequency. So if you get that diagram, so you can able to measure that how much magnitude of that wavefront. Okay, and if the magnitude is available, then you can calculate that how much time range is there. Okay, if you have that value of time range, so automatically you can calculate the frequency. Okay, so cathode is your negatively heated, and so you know that cathode terminal is negative and emit the electrons accurate towards the positive fluorescent scheme. So in cathode ray tube, na, so it's look like a tube. So scheme, that skin of that CRO is your display board, okay, display unit. So behind the display unit, some fluorescent skin is there. So okay, so cathode is means they are heated that cathode. So electron beams are coming from cathode to anode side. So what is your anode? It is your fluorescent skin. So after getting going through that path, okay, after going through that path, you are plotting lot of vertical plates and horizontal plates. Okay, so if you give that polarity, if you give that bias voltage of your vertical plate and horizontal plate, so that electron beam, it will influence. Okay, so if you provide some potential difference across your vertical and horizontal plate of that path flow through that cathode ray or electron beam, so definitely that movement will be there. If there is no potential, okay, so that plate is there situated in the way of that electron beam, so it is not biased with any voltage, so automatically it is electrons beam are emitted to the skin of that fluorescent skin, so there will be no deviations. If you give some polarity to that plate, so definitely it will deviate in that track. Okay, that path will be deviating. So that is your concept. Okay, so which parameters are having some effect to that cathode ray? So that is your intensity grid, focus grid, accelerating cannot, you can see, of that electron gun. So that total path is called that electron gun. Okay, so intensity of the grid means how much intensity of that electron path or electron beam you can observe here. That is important issue. Focus grid means where that it is focusing. That focus point should be, if you see the skin of that CRO, so we can see there is some vertical axis and horizontal axis. So at that point, vertical axis and horizontal axis is cutting each other, so that is your center point. Okay, so normally without having bias voltage, without having some additional additional voltage appear across your vertical and horizontal path, so that cathode beam, okay, should be focused at that center. Okay, where that vertical axis and horizontal axis cut each other. Okay, so you can say like that it is focused area. Then if you provide that potential difference, okay, across your voltage, across your x-axis plate and y-axis plate, okay, then what happened? That movement will, you can observe that movement of electron beams. Okay, that's the way to understand that how that how much difference is there and how it is working on it. Okay, so horizontal deflection plate, vertical deflection plate, that I am telling you, na? So if you provide some additional potential difference in horizontal, okay, that cathode beam or electron beam is passed through the horizontal plate. Okay, so if you give some of the voltage, so strength of the voltage is changed, so definitely there is some deflections of that cathode ray. Okay, so definitely cathode ray will be attracted with your positive plate of that horizontal, positive polarity path of that horizontal plate. Okay, horizontal plate, two horizontal plates are there, one will be the positively charged, another one will be the negatively charged. So positively charged plate, okay, definitely attract that electron beam. So the path of original original path of that electron beam will be deferred or will be shifted to that positive positively charged cathode plate, positively charged horizontal plate. Okay, same thing also happened for that vertical deflection plate also. So when it will be vertically presented and deflected, that movement of that cathode beam or electron beam in the vertical side. Okay, that's the basic operating phenomenon. Okay, when the electrons hit the skin, the phosphor is excited and emits light. Definitely, that phosphor skin is there behind of your display. Okay, so if that electrons are heated, okay, heat means it is directly punched to that phosphor plate. So it will be energized. Okay, so it will be energized due to the energized and excited. So phosphor will be excited and emit light, and you can understand the actual positions, okay, actual positions of your electron beams. Okay, then p resistance and how long that display glow. Okay, so it depends upon that material, okay, phosphor material compositions, how long it will be glow. Okay, may need to reduce the ambient light for the older instruments. So if that aging, due to the aging effect, that sensitivity and accuracy of that cathode of that phosphor elements, okay, so decaying, okay, sensitivity of that one, so that one reduce that ambient light. Okay, so the focus or intensity of that electron point is reduced. Okay, so connect a signal to the vertical deflection point. Okay, that I am told you that in vertical and horizontal reflection plate, so if you provide some of the signal, so definitely that ray motivation, so that motivates, that potential motivates the, or potential difference appear across your vertical deflecting plate, so that motivates, or that can cause for movement of your vertical movement of your electron beam in the display board. Okay, at same time, the voltage that increase the linearly with the time or the ramp is applied to the horizontal plate. So simultaneously you are providing that signals in your horizontal plate and that vertical plate. So vertical plate you are providing the direct vertical plate you are providing direct direct voltage. Okay, means potential appear across that vertical plates. Okay, and your horizontal plate you are providing that ramp signal. Okay, so that diagram is there. Here you can also see that ramp signal. Okay, so that ramp signal is there. Okay, that ramp signal is there, that you are, you can say like that is shortwave type waveform and appear across your horizontal. Okay, so vertical, this horizontal linear deflection is produced by the sweep generator, so it is called sweep generator. Okay, when the sweep signal is returned to zero in the end of the sweep, the beam flies back to is the start position. Okay, so when sweep is zero, so it will be in the start positions and beam is cut up during the flyback time. Okay, so it depends upon your positions of that beams. Okay, electron flow, the display is made appear to the stationary. So display is your stationary locations. Okay, this control your adjustment setting. So how much adjustment, so how much your voltage gain is there, time scale, so voltage scale and time scale. So there is some changing switch like your pot. Okay, so if you change that positions, if you change that positions, so automatically that display has changed. Okay, so that depends upon your setting. Okay, so the I see the waveform, now you are able to see the waveform, that X is in your horizontal axis and Y is in your vertical, or the height of the trace. Okay, so X is your horizontal portion and Y in your vertical. Okay, that two positions you can observe over here. The signal is, the signal is amplified by the vertical amplifier applied to the vertical plates. Okay, so vertical signal if you provide, so how much biasing is there, means how much bias voltage is there, so that amplifications you can observe in vertical side. Okay, and vertical amplified signal is applied to the sweep trigger. So you have also told you know that sweep mean or ramp signal is there in your y axis, so that may trigger your system. Okay, so sweep trigger generate a pulse. Okay, that sweep trigger generates a pulse coincident with the selected point in the cycle of the trigger signal, so that pulse is required for that trigger signal. So that which decide that cycle of the trigger signal, that sweep signal, okay, that ramp signal, okay. The pulse turns that sweep generator, initiating the shortwave waveform. So due to the presence of that plus pulse, that shortwave generation is there. The shortwave wave is amplified, okay, that shortwave wave is amplified by the horizontal amplifications applied to the horizontal deflecting plates. So you are providing that shortwave waveform of the ramp signal to the horizontal plate, and normal signal, okay, normal signal that is provided to the vertical plates, okay, and the signal strength of that vertical plates is it's motivate that electron beams, okay, that amplifications the in the x axis, in the y axis, okay. So that is important for that amplifying the signal state of strength of your vertical plate is deciding the amplifications level, the amplification level of your means in your horizontal side, means horizontal portion, means x axis, okay. So if you introduce more more power, okay, more intensity in your more bias voltage in your horizontal plate, so that may decide the strengthening of the signal length in your horizontal plate, okay. The trigger can be based on that 50 or the 60 hertz, okay. So how much range of this triggering, that is 50 to 60 hertz. That provision is made for an external trigger. So sometimes you can also go for the external trigger. Internal triggers, there is some fixed switching for there is some fixed pulse rate or the fixed repeating frequency, okay. If you want some any other range, okay, any other frequency range, so you have to give that external trigger, okay. Sometimes you are providing that clock pulse, so some of the measuring units, so you are to give that external clock to your system, okay. So if you fetch the data, if you want to fetch that data from your from the level of your external trigger signal, okay, so it is different from your inherently designed trigger signal frequency, both are different. So in that case you have to externally sending or feeding that value trigger signal to the system. That's why there is another options for your external trigger options, okay. So CRT tube control, so what are the most controlling factors for your cathode ray tube or cathode oscilloscope tube? So first one is the power on off. So definitely power is required. If you don't give that power, so there will be no heating effect in that cathode, okay. If there is no heating or there is no heat is generated in the cathode side, then what happened, that then electron beam will not be developed and that will not flow through that cathode terminal to your phosphor skin, okay, means anode terminal. So that's why power is important. Then the scale, okay, then scale of the display plate, okay. So how the range of the scale, okay, so what type of scale is there? Definitely linear scale is there. So ranging of that scale, that means it depends upon the setting, okay, setting of your X channel and Y channel, means channel 1, channel 2, normally 2 channel oscilloscope is there. For individual channel, individual units you can see from your X axis and Y axis. So you can set that setting in your Y axis, but in case of X axis, that is fixed for channel 1 and channel 2, okay, that is fixed. But sometimes some dedicated oscilloscope is there, that is called isolated oscilloscope. So that in that case, that timing is difference. If you want, you can differ that one. So most of the cases, that x axis is fixed for all the channels, okay, you are not going to differ that x axis value, okay, means for individual cases, mean individual oscilloscope platform, okay, normally it is same. Then after scaling, then important feature is the illumination, okay. So illumination is important. So how intensity, what illumination means what type of the color of that, so waveform color, okay, the color of the skin, okay. So that decided sometimes in DSO black side, you can see some of the color is there, that is light black color. Okay, then you can see the movement of that signal is in white in nature. Sometimes different color also be there, yellow, green, red, violet. Okay, so different color means different combinations are there. Okay, so in your phosphorus chain. Okay, so that decide that the combinations of that phosphor. Okay, so in illuminations, then focus. So if it is unbiased condition, if it is connecting at the cross section area, that means connecting the cutting point of your horizontal axis or vertical axis, if it is directly coincide that point or not, so that will be decided. Okay, so focus area is most important. Without, first you need to check it without giving any bias voltage. Okay, without giving any voltage in your X plate and Y plate, you need to check it, that focus point. If you have changed that, if you check that focus point is perfectly okay, then you can put that bias voltage and check that one, and you have to calibrate it. So some standard portion is there, okay, with the standard signal. So first you have to give that one, so it is written like that in testing of that any of the oscilloscope, when you are purchasing of the oscilloscope, or see, means it may be analog oscilloscope, it may be digital oscilloscope, whatever may be the oscilloscope are there. Okay, so you can check that some signal, there is some testing terminal. Okay, so some testing terminal is there, they are in oscilloscope. So it is written like that 5 volt, 2 volt, how much time period is there? Okay, 2 volt, 50 millisecond, like that way. So if that signal is generated, if you need to put connect that probe of that oscilloscope, so if that exact time and exact time and voltage amplitude is showing in that results of your oscilloscope, so we can say like that your oscilloscope is in calibrated one. Okay, if it is showing in different results, so you can say that your oscilloscope is not giving that exact results. Okay, that you need to cross check it before using the oscilloscope. Okay, so there is some issues of there is presence of some issues of calibration or not. Okay, so if there is no issues of calibration, so no problem, you can go ahead with your oscilloscope. Okay, so then the focus point. Okay, that's why I am telling you the focus point, the spot on the screen is most important with the presence of that bias voltage. The intensity, that means brightness of that electron beam. Okay, do not burn a spot on your skin. Okay, so that brightness of the skin also very important. Okay, so if it is not so prominent, so you are not able to see that value. Okay, so if you are not able to check that value, so there is some options, there is some scope for mistake of that response, means calculating that value. Okay, na? So that's why it is important. So intensity or the brightness, then vertical amplifications unit, so positions on the display. So vertical, if you give some signal on that vertical plate, so that may be responsible for amplifications in that vertical side of that instruments. Okay, so that is important. Then sensitivity of the vertical amplitude calibrated, so all the time you have to calibrate it, that perfect result is coming or not, and calculation fully in the clockwise, it depends from your convention. So they are considering that clockwise. So if you going for that design, if you want to design instrument that is your anti-clockwise convention, so there is no problem, but normally we are considering that clockwise configuration. So variable sensitivity, so sensitivity is a very important issue. So you can understand that how much sensible your instrument is, it you have to check, and continuous range between that calibrated state. Okay, so AC, DC and ground. Okay, so oscilloscope are able to measure that AC signal, DC signal and ground signal. Okay, so there is some changing of switch. Okay, so if you want to measure in AC terminal, so you have to put that switch to the AC terminal. Okay, so there is some changing options is there. So that is responsible for measurement in the AC platform. Okay, so if you want to see the same calculation in the DC platform, so what you need to do, so you have to change it to the DC, And what is your ground? So SCDC sometimes what happened, it is not, you can check it, that ground terminal is there. Okay, so that grounding options is there. So you can make it in ground option, no problem. So for which point you are getting that ground. So when you are going to measure that AC and DC, okay, so you can understand that which is your reference. So if you don't know that ground line, so how do you understand that which one is your reference? So find out that reference line. So first you have to put your switch in that ground terminal. Okay, then you need to check where the ground is there. So then there is some shifting of that ray, okay, shifting of that signal. Okay, so by changing that the pot, okay, that pot like switch is there, by using that, removing that switch from clockwise or anti-clockwise, you can shift the positions. Okay, you can shift the positions of any of the signal. So you can shift that position of ground in your x-axis. Okay, there is some x-axis, so x-axis you have put it, so that is zero. So you consider that x-axis value is zero, then you switch it to the DC, then you are able to measure the voltage. So you will get there is one division. Okay, means that DC voltage means fixed line. Okay, so it is coming one divisions above of your x-axis, in positive side above. So you can say like that, you have to calculate how much voltage per division. Okay, that you can calculate. So if you are able to get that value, so you are easily find out that how much voltage is applied to your oscilloscope, and you can calculate that value. In case of AC, same thing also happened. Okay, so how much deviations is in your positive Y, positive, that means how much deviation in your positive x-axis and positive positive y-axis and negative y-axis. So you can calculate that value. So by using that oscilloscope and only changing that switch position, so on off and ground, you are able to measure that AC DC values. Okay, select the desired coupling for that incoming signal. Okay, or ground amplitude input. So you have to calculate that first, calculate the ground portion, then AC DC measurement, so you can calculate the rest of the portions. Okay, so DC coupling signal directly to the amplitude. Okay, AC connects via capacitor block the DC. Okay, ground equal to no signal. Here you can see that the GND means ground. Okay, so GND means ground, no signal, and ground connect to the Y input to 0 volt. Check the position of 0 volt on screen. So you are giving in no volt. So if it would be the 0, means your instrument is okay, perfectly working well. Then horizontal sweep, so it is your vertical amplification. So then you can go for horizontal sweep. So horizontal sweep means you are giving that ramp signal to that horizontal. So sweep time per division, so it is called CM. The select the desired sweep rate or admit the external signal to the horizontal amplifiers. Okay, so how much amplification is there. Okay, that you can calculate, that how much time per division calculation, that is in your x-axis calculation. Okay, so here you can see the sweep time per CM or the variable, continuously variable sweep rates, and calculation is fully clockwise. Okay, so clockwise calculation you are going to be measured. Okay, so then positions that I am telling you, the clockwise, okay, that rotations of that position changing. Okay, that positions is control of the horizontal positions of the trace. Trace means that measurements. Okay, so that signal is coming to the fluorescent lamp, that we displace it. So tracing is there. Okay, so one tracing means the difference between two horizontal or vertical lines. Okay, so two lines you can select for measurement of time period or measurement the amplitude. So two set lines are there, so that is called trace. Okay, tracing, that it is coming from the tracing paper, na? So it look like the trace. Okay, horizontal variables are there. Okay, horizontal variables means the control of the attenuation of the signal applied to the horizontal amplifier through external horizontal connector. So if you want to try for external triggering, okay, so internal triggering no problem. Okay, so that by default configuration is there, that is coming to that horizontal plate. So for the external triggering, so you have to generate that signal from your laboratory, okay, and that and you need to put that signal to your horizontal plate. So there is some, see, in CRO there is some terminal is there that is called for external triggering. So in that case, that sweeping signal or horizontal signal you can prepare in your laboratory, and that amount of switching frequency based signal, okay, that amount of frequency based signal you can send to the oscilloscope through external triggering terminal. Okay, then trigger to the set of the auto normal. So normally two set of triggering is there, that is your auto or another means normal. So auto means automatically they will select that trigger value, okay, so by that oscilloscope, the processing unit of that oscilloscope, means by default, sometimes the by default result is there, okay, by default triggering values are there, so that is collected by the triggering pulse, okay, so collected by the horizontal plate, okay, so by default there is some value, but sometimes not even some sophisticated and specific analysis, okay, specific analysis by using that oscilloscope, so you have to develop some additional trigger frequency, so you can prepare it in the laboratory and you can connect that signal, okay, connect that signal to the external triggering terminal of the oscilloscope, okay, that's the options for the triggering. Okay, so triggering selects the timing and the being of that global horizontal sweep. Then slope, okay, next one is the slope. Select the trigger at the positive increasing or negative decreasing positions of the signal, so that is your slope. Okay, so we have to calculate it for that your horizontal or the sweep signal. So okay, how much slope is there? Okay, depending upon your slope. Okay, so the response fastness of the response of the measuring device is decided. Okay, so that's why the selecting of the switching frequency of the slope is most important features of that oscilloscope. Now coupling. So coupling means that select that trigger is at specific DC and AC level. So a coupling value means you are predefinedly you have fixed up some value, okay, that you can calculate beyond this value level, okay, so that is called coupling. Okay, so source, then from where you are giving the source may be in three way. Okay, that is internal source, that means vertical amplifier you are giving, external source from the external trigger input if it is necessary, line, okay, so line or the AC line 52 60 hertz system. So three things are sources are important. One is for sources for vertical amplifier, okay, and next one is that external amplifier for the fixed trigger input, okay, or sometimes the manual means automated amplifications or automated ramp signal is connected to your sensor, so that is responsible for movement. Vertical amplification is responsible for the movement of that signal in Y path, and external from your external trigger input or any of the trigger input that is responsible for that shifting or the movement of the signal, okay, spreading movement of the signal in X axis, and finally that line frequency. Okay, so line frequency in India it is 50 hertz. Okay, so we have to use that instrument is working on that line frequency. If that instrument is not working, if that equipment, if that application is not there, so who is going to be measure that value? Okay, that's why it is also important addition. So volt per division of the switch. So normally volt per division is adjustable configuration, and that is considered in your Y axis. Okay, so volt per divisions, all the cases. Another one is time per division switch, that is considered for your X axis, and volt per divisions is considered for your Y axis. Okay. Vertical modes, for in vertical modes, you can see that different channels. So channel 1 and channel 2 are there for each operated separately. So channel 1 and channel 2 both can operate separately, but one thing is fixed, that is your time range. So time range for channel 1 and channel 2 is always fixed. You are not able to change that different time range for channel 1 and channel 2. So by default one time changing terminal is there. Okay, so if you change the terminal, so all both the cases mean channel 1 condition, channel 2 condition, that vertical movement, sorry, that horizontal movements may differ, but that frequency of that horizontal movement is same, okay, all the cases for your channel 1 movement and channel 2 movement. But you can amplify that vertical terminal may be different, but X terminal for both of the configuration for channel 1 and channel 2, it is same. So dual channel 1 and channel 2 at the sweep alternately. So normally in channel 1 and channel 2, what happened? You are individually working on it. So channel 1 by default, x-axis the time range is there. Channel 2 by default in x-axis the time range is there. Okay, so both channel 1 and channel 2 time range is similar. Okay, but y-axis the parameter may be different. For channel 1 you are going to calculate that voltage. In channel 2 you are going to measure that current. Okay, but time domain is fixed. Okay, so sometimes what happened? For external period, okay, you are giving some external signal to your external triggering terminal, okay, and channel 1 you are putting that current, channel 2 you are putting that voltage. I think all of you will understand. So as per the deciding that clock pulse, that triggering signal, external triggering signal, the clock pulse of the triggering signal, so that will decide that how much that value is, that how much time that you need to be stored that value, how much time that calculation will be done. So it will be decided sometimes by the external triggering. In that case, channel 1 and channel 2, none of them are the time variables. Okay, so both are time dependent. Okay, so there is no time, okay, in that case for the dual channel. So why dual? The dual that use a measure input and output signal of a device under the test. So you are going the testing. Okay, so in the testing purpose you can go for that calculations. Okay, then channel 1 and channel 2 has been added. Okay, sometimes mathematical calculations you can going to perform. Okay, so for additions of two of the channel voltage, multiplications of their voltage and current for both of the channels, so power calculation, then energy calculations. Okay, so if you know that amount of voltage is there, so how much current is there in your channel 1 calculation, channel 2 calculation, so that all can done by your different calculations in between channel 1 and channel 2. But in that case, that storing energy, storing data is mandatory. Okay, so you have to store that data value. Okay, so that is important. Then time based analysis. Okay, so time based analysis mean mean max. Okay, mean max mean. Okay, so mean max mean, so all the delay that you can going to be calculated, select the sweep of the main mix or the delay mode, also XY switch. Okay, time per division provides the selection of the switching rate, that I told you. Now time per division means X axis question. So sweep rate you have to calculate, the range of 0.1 second, the range of 0.1 second or 50 to 1 millisecond or 52.01 microsecond per division, not 5 to 1 at the sequence. So we have to maintain the sequence. Okay, as per the point given by that IEEE standards. Okay, to determine the frequency, use this reciprocal of your time period. Same thing, you know, all of the frequencies 1 by time period. So 50 hertz frequency means 20 milliseconds. Okay, the time period is 1 by frequency. Okay, simple thing, time frequency, time is 1 by frequency, there is nothing big issue. Then different tests are there, so allow the individual components to be tested. Okay, so that is called component test. Now connect the via banana jacks. Okay, test the resistor, capacitor, diode and transistor, etc. Calculations is deliver that calibrated voltage, example 2 volt peak to peak. Okay, 1 kilohertz square wave for the setting, for the setting scale. Okay, then ground, that calculation of ground, where is your earth normal terminal is calculated there. So sometimes what happened in common ground problem also been appeared. Okay, different cases. So when you are dealing with that instrument in practical cases, so different practical problems you can you may face. Okay, so that common ground problem is very simple and common example. Okay, means that same ground is there, so some of the current is flowing, that circulating current is there in between two common grounds. Okay, so that common ground problem means at a moment you can only measure Okay, so why isolation is important? Okay, so you are measuring the potential across a resistance, means in oscilloscope two terminals is there, one is negative terminal, one is positive terminal. So negative terminal means it is in ground potential, and positive terminal means that your unknown value you are going to be measured. So that voltage appear in between that positive and negative. Okay, so means in you are making that voltage, you try to measure that voltage from your across a resistance. Okay, so you are able to measure that value. See, now what happened, one inductor is connected series with that resistance, and simultaneously you want to measure that channel one, that inductor voltage, in channel two in resistance voltage appear across that resistance and inductance. Then what happened, if you both are inductor and capacitor resistance, both are in series, so first you put that positive in channel positive, means oscilloscope having two channels, so two channels having individually two terminals, so one positive terminal, one negative terminal. So positive terminal were connected to the one half of the one point of that inductor, and negative terminal were connected another terminal of the inductor. Okay, now you want to do the simultaneous measurement that across your inductor voltage and resistance voltage. Okay, that resistance is connected series of that inductor, so that connection of inductor is already there. Now you want to do the connections across the resistance, means now again another positive terminal of that oscilloscope you want to put to the one terminal of the resistance, and negative terminal put another terminal of the resistance. Then what happened, that inductor back side is connected to the forward side of that resistance, then inductor back side is connected is negative terminal of the oscilloscope, and resistance front side is connected to the positive terminal of that channel 2 of the same oscilloscope. Then what happened, the channel 1 and channel 2, okay, the channel 1 ground and channel 1 positive, channel 1 ground is connected behind of your inductor, and channel 2 positive is connected front side of your resistance. Okay, your inductor and resistance both are connected in series. Then what happened, then positive negative both are connected in the same terminal, na? Then there is a big problem that is called common ground problem. So if the individual channel of that oscilloscope is isolated each other, okay, then that problem will not be there. Isolated each other means then both of the ground is different. Okay, so different ground. So if you have four channel oscilloscope and individual channel is isolated with another channel, okay, the same oscilloscope, okay, so you can make it, you can call it that isolated channel oscilloscope, okay, and you are able to measure that value. Okay, that's why that ground of that ground terminal is most important. Okay, so you have to keep in your mind. Okay, so connections at the vertical input, horizontal input, external trigger, and calculation out. Okay, that four connections are there. Simple thing, vertical input means vertical for the amplification, vertical amplification. Horizontal input means x side, so x side switching terminals. Okay, external trigger, I think you know about it, so external triggering, and calculation output is there. Okay, then the bandwidth, that how much bandwidth. So I think in my next class I will started with that bandwidth and the rest of the questions. Okay, so I think this is enough for today's class. So I think after my class there is another classes are there. Okay, so just wait. I hope all of you are able to understand till now. So if you have any kinds of difficulties, any kinds of confusion, you please ask me, so I can rediscuss some of the portions. Okay, so that is enough for today's session. So in my next